I qualified from Moroto Teachers College. It's a co-PTC. I was given employment at Rainbow Primary School, where I stayed for quite some time. It was a community school, and that school was merely, it was in a slum environment, in a place called Achol Inn. Achol Inn was by then known for a lot of havoc. People had guns, fighting, there was a lot of drinking and careless living. So we went there and we began a ministry, and the community said they wanted a school. So we started like a school as a feeding center. I was the first head teacher, very young from college, and I was the head teacher. So, you know, that these children who are, they feel they're rejected, you know, it was a slum area. They were dirty, but we went there, we would bathe these children. We had a borehole nearby and we would bathe the children, bring them to school. Wild Food gave us some food. So we would give these children porridge, then some lunch. And they had a lot of interest now, because it was a slum area, we had to fence around. We used reeds to fence around so that they're in an environment. And we kept staying with them. Sometimes we'd move with them to the villages nearby, Manyatas, and we tell the children we can go to school. So that those who would come to stand around the fence with their sheets around their waists, observing what's happening, they will wait to wash the saucepans and eat the residue down there. But this time I told them, no, you can go to class. So there are some boys I pulled inside, come. And right now they're counselors in Moroto. I was in that school for 7 years, and it grew expressly from a feeding center to a primary school and sat PLE in 2003. So later on, I was transferred to a place called Lope Sub-County, a primary called Lope Primary School, 209. There are a lot of insecurities around that place. The warriors from the neighboring community in Kotido would come as early as even 4 p.m. coming for raids, and they would even raid food from the saucepans. So the school at that time became like a place where people would run to for rescue. So I would accommodate the people, but my interest was for children. At one level, some warriors shot at 2 children. So like you are hiding in a bathroom and guns, and the children are crying in the villages. Parents are crying and are calling you and saying, Mwalimu, what do we do? People will call me at night. They say, Mwalimu, if you cannot help us, then where will you get the children to teach? Because we are going to move to another place. And that one forced the cow to give me an assignment as a sub-county chief at the same time. And it helped us because during that time, you know, I had double powers. And we mobilized children to go to school because now I was in the realm of education. We opened 3 community schools in Lope sub-county. And actually, they're still there. By then, Lope was producing children to go to the streets. Kids would leave, they ran to go and work domestic chores in other districts and in towns and even in Kampala. So somehow, we attracted children to come to school in Lope sub-county. Because in the villages, you are a doctor, you are a teacher, you are an advisor. If there are any meets, you are called. At school level, you know, education is more important than the uniform. I wouldn't want a child to stay home because he doesn't know what? Uniform. So if a piece of uniform costs 20,000, how many kilos of posho will a parent buy? So they feel they would rather buy food than what? Go for uniform. Because we believe if the boys are not educated, they will be the one turning back to become warriors who will be carrying guns. And worse are those semi-literate ones. They're very violent when they are found on the roads. So we believe that all the boys and girls should be taken to school, and if possible, harnessed